All-Pro cornerback Xavien Howard skipped the mandatory Miami Dolphins minicamp over his contract situation. There are several ways the stalemate involving Xavien Howard and the Miami Dolphins could play out over the next several weeks, up to and including a trade. That obviously would be the most drastic scenario because it would mean the departure of the team's most talented player just 1 year after he led the NFL with 10 interceptions and finished third in the voting for NFL Defensive Player of the Year. But it's not as though the Dolphins have been afraid to make major moves in recent years. It was always believed after he changed agents last season that Howard would want a new contract because of his performance last year and how he went from the highest-paid cornerback in the NFL to not even tops on the team after the signing of Byron Jones last offseason. The contract issue came to the forefront on the first day of minicamp this week when Flores acknowledged it was the reason the 2016 second-round pick wouldn't be at the team's facility all week. Howard and his agent, David Cantor, felt strongly enough about their position that they subjected him to fines up to a little more than $93,000 for skipping the only mandatory portion of the offseason program. On performance alone, there's no question that Howard should be the highest-paid cornerback on the team because his performance in 2020, when he tied the franchise record for interceptions, ranked among the most dominant by any Dolphins defensive player ever. But there's the other side, of course, and that's the reality that it was only 2 years ago, May 9, 2019, to be precise, that Howard signed a 5-year contract extension. The other reality is that Howard is under contract through the 2024 season and the Dolphins don't have to do anything. If the Dolphins hold firm, Howard's only recourse is to simply not show up for training camp, but he again would subject himself to fines. The Dolphins also could eventually agree with Howard's position and rework his contract, but they could view that as setting a dangerous precedent for any player who outperforms his contract. The Dolphins obviously are a better team with Howard on the roster, so they'll have to decide what becomes more important. Then there's the scenario of Howard eventually giving up on the idea of an immediate contract restructure, but under the scenario we're looking at the strong possibility of having an unhappy player on the team, and a key one at that.